Greetings, this is the first in a series of introductory overview primers on flashlights by the flashlight reviewer Selfbuilt. I frequently get asked questions about what some of the terms and some of the detailed testing that I do in my reviews all means, and I thought it'd be useful to kind of give a series of overviews that explain the various characteristics and functions of a light so you can kind of better understand some of the detailed testing that I do. To start, I thought it might just be worthwhile to go back to basics and discuss what exactly a flashlight is. Basically, it's just a portable lighting instrument, I guess a modern version of fire on a stick, in essence. And actually, that even gets back to what the name is. In English North American, we refer to these things as flashlights. Most of the English-speaking world, though, tends to call them torches, which is actually a fairly good indicator of what their job is and where they historically come from. Other languages can be interesting too. In French, we call these lampes de poche, or pocket lights, which is another good idea getting around their, you know, portability. What I'm holding here in my hand is not something I would normally review, but it's probably familiar to you. This is kind of the quintessential flashlight for most people, a 2D cell flashlight, incandescent bulb, very basic, simple plastic build, simple switch up here near the head, where you, when you turn it on, you get that kind of sickly orange, irregularly shaped beam. This is kind of the flashlight most of us grew up with. Most people have one of these kicking around in their house. This one I've had for about 20, 25 years. You can see it's a little beat up. Works well, not much to go wrong with it, other than the fact that the bulb can break fairly easily if you drop it. Just to sort of show you the insides. Again, this is a 2D cell flashlight. Probably about the only time you use D cells because the capacity required by these inefficient incandescents. Inside, I'll get an extra light out so you can see what's going on here. So it's a simple plastic construction tube. There's a metal spring at the end with a metal wire underneath that runs up to the switch on the side. And so the way that this works is very simple. You connect the negative terminal of the battery through that spring up through the wire. And this physical switch simply moves it in connection or not. If you make the contact, it continues up to the positive point up here of the battery, which is also in contact with the light. And that's basically all it is. You're simply putting the light bulb in the path of the circuit with the two batteries, and the light comes on. And in this case, all you have is a very simple bulb. There's no circuit. There's just a direct connection to the batteries. So this is what's known as running direct drive in flashlight parlance. There's no circuit. There's nothing complicated. The amount of light you get simply reflects the battery capacity and how much life is left in the batteries. So when light will come on strong, and it'll decay over time as it gets weaker and weaker as the batteries drain. And that's basically it, a very simple, straightforward light. Of course, you know, for years now, there have been other options for lights that are a little more complex. This, for example, is a clone or a knockoff of the Surefire 6P, which is a very popular build flashlight. This is the Solar Force L2, one of many companies that sort of knock off the classic build and use interchangeable parts. This is all aluminum construction, so you don't have a kind of switch on the side that connects the front to the top. The way this works, sort of open up the tail cap here. So you've got two batteries, and we'll start here. These are camera batteries, CR123As. Give you a little more output. We'll talk more about that in some of the other reviews. But basically the way this works is you've got a clicky switch on the tail cap. And these switches are very simple. Here's just to give you an example of the switch on its own or something similar. The way this works is there are little metal flanges on the side of the plastic. And there's the metal connecting spring. You click, you can see how the little switch works. All this really does is open or close a contact. And then the current can flow from the spring off to these little metal clips on the side that connect with the body in the tail cap, which is in turn connected to the rest of the body. So what happens is the negative path is carried by the body through this tail cap up to the head. So that's one kind of difference you'll see on most modern lights. There's a tail cap clicky. This is a very convenient point to put a spring-mounted tail cap in the traditional body shape of this kind of flashlight. These types of flashlights are a little bit different as well, in that you have more than just a simple bulb. This is actually also an incandescent flashlight. Most of what I test is LED lights. But this one has a whole lamp assembly. So you can see there's a small incandescent light bulb in the center of that reflector. There's a circuit underneath there. You can see it's kind of hard to see with all the metal. There's an exterior spring connecting to the body and an interior spring connecting to the positive battery terminal, but there's a circuit in between, and the circuit allows you to control more of how the light operates. Pretty much all the LED flashlights that I test are circuit controlled in some way, and this gives you a lot more options and what you can do. Even on an incandescent, it'll give the option, for example, you can regulate the output of the flashlight. So it's not just direct drive. You can have a circuit draw more power from the batteries to try to maintain a more constant output. That's one aspect you'll see of these kind of lights. I should also show you as well, you can see there's a much better beam there. The reason for that is it uses a much better quality lamp assembly, but it also has a much better quality reflector. And these are all things I'll talk about in some of my other reviews, but just to give you an idea of how, you know, the kind of build that you see in a typical flashlight. It can get more complicated than that. Here, for example, is a flashlight that uses a side-by-side battery arrangement instead of the batteries in direct series. Here, instead, you have a battery carrier. It holds the two cells on opposite sides, but they're connected together in a similar sort of way. There's, again, a physical switch. You know, just another type of approach, and you have to have a way to connect the positive and negative terminals, you know, here in the head. So now we're getting a more complicated design and build, but it's still another efficient way to sort of carry flashlights together. This is an incandescent flashlight, a lot brighter, but it has also modes that you can switch through. And again, I'll talk about all of this in more detail in my other reviews, just want to give you a bit of an overview of what a flashlight looks like. The next in this series of flashlight overviews will be an explicit discussion of the build, so the physical characteristics of lights, which is usually one of the first things I start talking about in my reviews. So thanks, and stay tuned for more.